Hello and welcome to Chairside Live. I'm your host, Megan Strong. In today's show, Dr. Chi has a patient in his chair with severe occlusal decay on tooth number 31. The patient experiences pain when biting, as well as sensitivity to cold. So what to do, what to do? Well, Dr. Chi removed the decay, placed an indirect pulp cap, and then restored with none other than Camouflage Flowable and Universal Composite. Let's check out how it all comes together in this exciting restorative case. Over to you, Dr. Chi.
For this case, we have a patient that has a chief complaint of thermal and pressure sensitivity in the lower right quadrant. Our examination reveals severe occlusal decay on 31. The plan is to perform a caries cleanout and a direct camouflage composite restoration. The objective for any caries removal is to first identify the extent of the decay. Here I'm using a medium grit round end tapered diamond to extend the preparation in all directions until I locate uninfected DEJ. You are able to use any gross reduction burr of your choice. Because I'm focused on the DEJ initially, I only have the burr extend to a depth of about 2 millimeters. Once a clean DEJ ring around the prep is achieved, I complete the rest of the caries removal with a slow speed round burr along the axial walls while with light pressure, carefully advance apically. I like to use caries indicator dye as an aid to help guide where demineralized tooth structure is, but keep in mind there may also be false positives. I see that there's a crack line through the distal marginal ridge, but since there isn't any signs of leakage or decalcification, I like to bond directly to these areas. At a depth of about 4 millimeters from the occlusal surface, I do begin to see the pulp horns. It's best to leave any affected dentin to avoid pulpal irritation and further complications. At this depth, I condition the cavity with polyacrylic acid for 20 seconds and then apply gluma for a minute. We then complete the indirect pulp cap with a thin layer of Vitrebond along the pulpal floor. Now the cavity is ready for bonding. We etch with Caries 37% phosphoric acid and follow that with an adhesive application using 3M's Scotch Bond Universal. Always use a gentle stream of oil-free air after applying the adhesive until it stops moving. This will ensure that the solvents have fully evaporated and a maximum bond can be achieved. I begin the restoration with a thin layer of camouflage flowable to adapt to the pulpal floor. Then I build up the restoration with Camouflage Universal A1 enamel. The material is very easy to adapt to the cavity walls and shape to the desired form. I place and cure each cusp's support individually. I use an explorer also to define, at the end, the primary anatomy between each cusp slope. With a slow speed round burr, I'll remove any excess along the margins and adjust any high occlusal spots. I then finish with some rubber tip composite polishers to achieve a smooth surface. We were able to successfully restore the patient with a direct camouflage resin restoration that's both strong and provides great natural aesthetics. 2 days after the procedure, the patient reached out to me and told me all of the pain and sensitivity has stopped. As a clinician, it's gratifying to be able to take our patients out of pain and address their issues in the least invasive way possible. Thanks for tuning in for this episode. We'll see you on the next one.
Thank you for that, Dr. Chi. Well, that about wraps it up for this episode of Chairside Live. So on behalf of everyone here at Glybal Laboratories, thank you for watching, and I'll meet you right back here next time.